We didn't want to go. All right, thank you. Thank you, Minya, for coming by. And, we apologize for keeping you waiting. But today we rose Parliament to 10th of September for us to come back for the independent Parliament, as well as we coincided Parliament returned with the scheduled visit by His Holiness Pope Francis. I just want to say thank you to all people right across our country. I do apologize for the extraordinary debacle that took place in Parliament this afternoon. Parliament is the house that is controlled by numbers. Number dictates all transactions of Parliament. Whether to come and sit in Parliament and Parliament convenes, that is dependent on a quorum, or Parliament transactions, every vote that takes place in Parliament is conducted by vote. Even an aye or a nay is a vote that is taking place, and the Speaker's role is to sit in the chair trying to coordinate where the majority favor is. And I just want to indicate to all of us that we've completed, as we said, 2 weeks of Parliament sitting. Some may say that Thursday is not including two weeks recess, but most of government business has been retired in what we wanted to do in this sitting, and so we've got Parliament to September. The much contested issue in terms of the submissions by VONC, I just want to ask our country, put the question back to those who fill in the forms. The 5 technical requirements of a VONC is prescribed. It's set in stone, it's set in law. The Speaker has no discretion on it. The private business committee has no discretion on it. Let's just go through what is requirement of law, and requirement of the standing orders, and requirement of constitution. And so those are clearly outlaid. The Speaker has indicated that for clarity for the public to know whether he's in the right or is the committee is in the right or wrong, he will go to court. And the government looks forward to joining in court. And we also appeal to opposition. They're certainly most welcome to go to court for clarity and for public records and for precedents to be established. Change of government or proposal to change government is no easy, lightweight matter. It is a core, substantial, constitutional matter. You're changing a government that sought mandate at the people through the election process. You want to change government? Every 10 numbers must present to take control of Parliament and to change the government through the due processes. Now, it has become apparent, not just once, not twice, 3 times, 4 times, today, 5th time in a row. And if I was members of the opposition, I would look within and ask again, how comes we made mistakes in 5 consecutive attempts to fill in a basic form that goes towards fulfilling the requirement of law and standing order? And so the question should be put back to them in how comes they failed to do it correctly. In all 5 instances, and I am happy that the Speaker is going to the courts to clarify himself, and I want to advocate that the process is clear. Court only will clear whether the private business committee was right or wrong. And the Speaker is the chair of the court. The issue of names, the name that is prescribed on the writs that is returned to the government house and to the parliament is the name of the person that must sign onto the form. So I think they from what we get it along the corridors, there are about 6, once again, the physical numbers. We had 69 that stood with government, supporting the motion for adjournment. And I just want to appeal to our citizens nationwide. Don't get caught up in the play that is played by opposition. With no numbers, they continue to create nuisance in the public place. You know, talk about the constitutional rights, of course that is within their right. But that right comes at the back of majority number to change the course of government this time. They failed in February, they failed again. In May to produce the numbers. They can attempt again in September, but work, unfortunately, is disturbed in our country. Members of Parliament, ministers of cabinet, and the government needs to work. And so we've got then 2 September facing independence, and in between now and then, we will continue on working in what we set out to do in as far as our 2024 work plan is concerned. I want to thank our members of the coalition, all coalition parties, since we started 2024, have remained firm and together. Not just PAMGU Party that lost 12 of the 59, but more importantly, URP, SDP, People's First Party, People's Party, NA, National Alliance Party, People's Movement for Change, the Melanesian Liberal Party, Melanesian Alliance, and of course, the PNG Party that will join us. In government today, on strength, we are 76. The last time I said 77. It is 76 in the last count. So 76 out of a parliament of 110 means majority is on our side. We will get on with the business of doing work for our country. Any question, please? Just a few questions and then I'll... No more question, Lisa? Yes?
I would like to know why you asked for that motion of dissent.
Well, it's prescribing law.
But if you're saying that you have the numbers, why are you, like many of us can see that the government is avoiding this vote? Why can't the government just face the vote of your government?
The government is not avoiding it. We've given them opportunity 2 weeks now. They have to get the echo. It's not someone's stopping place in parliament. They prescribed ways to get on doing the vote of no confidence process. And so they did not do it properly. That's why I said go back and ask them.
So I may have, Prime Minister, I may have misunderstood, but when the speaker said that he made that ruling, and that's when you stood up to that motion of the dissent. Yes. So why did you move?
Section 96 of the standing order calls that someone can move a dissent. And as I said earlier, when a motion is moved or a dissent is placed, it won't give the free advisory. You defeat government motions by sole numbers on the floor. You take control of the parliament. And so the dissent technically for me too was to show to the country that the number is not on the side. It's just simply a waste of time. It's an academic exercise. You know, and also the speaker, mind you, the speaker came in, they didn't allow the speaker to complete. His readings. They attacked him from where go. The speaker would have said, all right, you got these defects, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Fix it up and bring it back. The speaker would have said this. But they shut down the speaker from what, you know, they were, the word go. As if they had the number, we had to show them they did not have the number by that set.
Prime Minister, one is from PNG Sun. I've got 2 questions here. First one is, what's your message to the business community and the public service now that they are not at work concentrating in light of the looming VOMC against your government? And the second one is, you've announced that PAMGU Party will meet on the 6th of this month. And what are we expecting? What are the...
Thank you, Wapis. To the business community and to the public service, especially to the public service, they shouldn't be caught in politics. Continue working impartially. Members of parliament will do their job. Today, in the opposition and government divide, government maintains majority up to today. The last time, they came to fill in something. You know, guess what? They just uploaded what they feel to the Facebook, to get the access of what they did, and unfortunately, they had defects in the submission they did must do. So it's a serious matter. They must do it properly. That's prescribed by law and the standing orders. And I want to appeal to our business community, need not panic, remain at work. Government will go to work. We discussions on Wafi Golpu will be progress to ensure we conclude on Wafi Golpu. Discussions on other projects are running. And business community are encouraged. We've had from 1975 up till 2002 about 12 government formations. And from 2002 2022 or 24 now, three prime ministers. All our businesses are encouraged, needless to be fearful and apprehensive. Government come, government go, but Papua New Guinea we live on. So for business community, remain at work. We will get to you in where government needs to come to you. For public service, as usual, your code of ethics demands that you don't get engaged in politics. You want to come back, it's a free country. It's only 20% of the 59 members that have vacated Pangu in this instance and are sitting on the opposite. We lose no sleep if they don't come back. Life moves on. As leaders, they are totally entitled to make their own call of association. At this point in time, they felt that they're comfortable at the opposite side. Let them sit there. Tomorrow, Pangu Party will dispense with in accordance to the provisions of our party constitution as to how we deal with those members who choose to sit at the opposite.
You're putting your leadership up on the table for contention?
Well, no, leadership is always on the table. Leadership is always on the table. Pangu Party leadership is always on the table. My leadership was affirmed by the convention proper that we held in, I think, early this year. In the last council, it wasn't an issue. Tomorrow, as we go to the Pangu Party meeting, in the Pangu room, if there's someone who wants to put his hand up, that's an internal Pangu matter. But there are two leadership differences. The prime ministership I have is a parliamentary business matter. The mandate is sourced from parliament. But the party leadership is sourced from party caucus. Two separate, distinct leadership ascension parties.